Good evening. Okay, so let others join. From 6:20, your class will start. Okay.
Detection problem.
Okay, so good evening again, everyone. Am I audible and is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so in previous class, RL RC circuit was complete. Okay. So up to RL and RC circuit, that means up to your PPT number 2.3, that was already uploaded, okay, in Google Classroom. So you can see there. And everyone take the snapshot of these questions, okay? This is your homework for today and tomorrow. If you can solve this, post in the group. Okay, this is based on your previous class. Actually, I forgot to show you this one in previous class. That's why I am giving you this today. Okay, everyone write down the question or you can take the snapshot. Okay, so have you taken?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So I hope the RL RC circuit and the phasor diagram concept, the main concept is clear, right? So before starting, okay, someone is also joining right now. So before starting, can you tell me in your house, okay, at home, there are numbers of fans, numerous lights, okay, and you have so many appliances, right? Like fridge and some induction oven, geyser, okay? So these appliances are connected how? In which manner? That means whether it is series or parallel. Do you know that?
Parallel.
So these equipments are connected in parallel, and I hope you have seen at home that sometimes if you run maximum amounts of appliances, the fuses were blown, or sometimes there are MCB, like miniature circuit breakers. Okay, so circuit breaker trips. So why that happens?
Due to extra load.
Okay, extra load means?
Means in a 5 amperes plug, we attach too much amperes of plugs, so there is extra load. Due to that, MCB breaks down.
Very good. That means the extra load, if you put extra load, that means the extra consumption of current, right? So if you see that there are the connected MCBs, okay, in below the MCB, you will see that there is one rating written on that MCB, okay? And if you see the fuses, the box of the fuse, then you will see that in the backside of that fuse, one rating is written, right? Like 5 ampere or 16 ampere or 32 ampere, like that, right? So if more amount of load you draw, the maximum amount of current will be fed into your system, and if that rating exceeds, then your circuit will blow, okay, and the MCB will trip. Now what is the difference? Do you know the difference between MCB and the fuse?
Yes, sir.
So what is the difference, can you tell me?
In MCB, if there is a short circuit at any place, the MCB goes down. While in fuse, it gets burned. We have to connect another wire to the fuse.
Good. So you know already 80% of the difference. Actually, the MCB, see, you are learning here basic electrical engineering. Okay, so basic electrical engineering is not about what you are learning for a temporary purpose, okay? Whether you are going to be one IT engineer or some mechanical engineer, but at your home, whatever you see, they are all merged into one, right? So whether you are one IT engineer, but you're one mechanical engineer, you must have one basic knowledge, and that basic knowledge you will get from this basic electrical engineering. That's why this is included in your syllabus. Okay, so not only this, your MCB is only for short circuit case, it is also for overload condition also. What is the meaning of overload? Overload means the rating of for one house, for one particular room. Suppose one particular room, the maximum rating of the MCB connected there is 32 ampere, okay? But if you are drawing the current of 33 ampere, okay, due to the tolerance limit, the circuit will not blow, okay? That is called overload condition. What is the meaning of short circuit? The phases are connected with each other. Okay, two wires are shorted. That is called short circuit. So MCB help you. MCB always helps you to save your connection, your electrical connection, not only from short circuit case, also from overloading case also. Okay, see, I have one some animated diagram. Okay, if I get time, I will show you. Right, actually your syllabus is little big for your, with respect to your time duration, that's why I didn't get time. I will show you. Okay, so that goes based on your general knowledge basically. Now we are going to the syllabus, according to your syllabus. Okay, now is the screen visible? That is module 2 lecture 4.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay, so here we are going to learn the RLC series circuit. Okay, that you already performed that in lab experiment. Okay, so what is RLC series circuit? And I already gave you some basic idea yesterday. Okay, so what is the impedance of RLC series circuit, the concept of resonance, and some numerical based on that. Right, so first, this is your PPS here, right? It is looking like this. Okay, don't worry. So this is your RLC series circuit analysis. Okay, who is waiting there? Okay, so here you can see one resistor is here, one inductor and one capacitor. Are connected as source. This VS is connected, correct? And due to the close connection, current is flowing. Now tell me, which one is your reference?
Voltage.
Why voltage? They
current.
Current. Exactly. I am telling you repeatedly that which variable is constant for all the elements. If you are taking one series circuit and current I is flowing, then which one is same? Is the voltage same across these elements? No. This voltage is VR. This voltage is VL. So they are not same, but current flowing through these elements are same. So the variable or the current here is same for these elements. So here current is your reference. Always keep remember this one. Right, now if anyone tells you that okay, you know this concept, then tell me about the parallel circuit. So in parallel circuit, which one is same, voltage or current?
Voltage,
sir.
Right. So in that case, voltage will be your reference. Correct? So here, look, series circuit is here. Yes, correct. So voltage is for parallel circuit. Okay. So in this case, here we are discussing only for the series circuit. I will discuss again for parallel circuit also, what will happen there. So here you can see the voltage VR is developed, voltage VL is developed, and voltage VC is developed due to the flow of current. Okay, so now you can see the circuit elements, the resistance R. For inductor, what is your inductance value? L. And it is in Henry. Henry is its unit. Okay, so we have to convert this into ohm, correct? So how to convert it? Multiply with omega L, correct? Similarly, in case of capacitor, what is your capacitance value? That is C, and unit is farad, right? So you cannot use this in the circuit. So you have to convert this one into the capacitive reactance, okay? So this is called the inductive reactance. Remember these terms. Okay, this is called inductive reactance. Okay, this one is called capacitive reactance. Correct. Now, this is this omega L we can write as ZL equals to J omega L. Why J omega L? Because this omega L value is always in positive y axis. Correct. And this ZC is in negative y axis. Okay. So here, look, you can get it also from the phasor diagram. So try to draw the phasor diagram in your own copy, okay, and check whether you are getting like this or not. Since I is our reference, so I am drawing here I, correct? And due to the current flow, the voltage VR is developed across the resistor. So I and VR are in which condition? Phase or lagging or leading?
In phase.
In phase. Exactly. So this is your in phase system, right? And if current is your reference, then how VL will be placed?
So lead by 90 degrees.
Lead by 90 degrees. Exactly. So it will be in leading condition by 90 degrees. And always remember the x axis refers the real term, the real component of your circuit, okay? And the vertical axis, or you can say the positive y or negative y axis, they represents the imaginary terms. Clear? Now, this is your I. So how VC will be drawn? VC will be in minus 90 degree, okay? So this is your VC. Okay, now what is VR? VR is nothing but I into R, correct? And what is VL? VL is nothing but your I into XL, correct? And since it is in positive Y axis and they are imaginary, so that imaginary term J must be there, okay? So This is your current. Don't get confused. I and J. The I is your current and J is included here because it is in imaginary, in nature. Okay. So similarly, for VC, I can write this I into XC with minus J. Isn't it? Is the concept clear till now?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, good. So is there any no, sir? Kisi ko samajh mein nahi aaya, aisa koi hai? Good. So this minus JXC, so I can write this one as I, that is your current, into minus of JXC, correct? And this one I am writing as I into JXL. Okay, so this XL is nothing but omega L. So here you can see it is matching, correct? And how it is matching? See, what is J? I can convert this plus 1 into minus of J square. I can write this or not? Tell me. Minus of J square I can write?
Yes, sir.
Divided by J into omega C. So 1J will be cancelled out. So from here, you are getting what? Minus of J by omega C. Okay. So from here, you can write this value is minus J into XC. Is it okay now? Clear one?
Sir, why is that J squared instead of 1?
Okay, that means you just forgot the imaginary concept. What is J? What is J? Or imaginary term, what is J? That is root under of minus 1, isn't it? Do you remember this?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir, I understood that.
Okay.
So, yes.
Okay, good. So you, from here you can write that J square equals to minus 1. That is your in your 11th syllabus, I think. Imaginary
yes, sir, real
chapter. Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Okay, yes, real imaginary. Exactly. Okay. So now we can proceed with our original calculation. So this phasor diagram, I hope it is okay. Correct. Now, next you can see with this waveform. Okay. See here, VR is in phase. VL leads the current. Here, VL leads the current because extend this one. Okay. This one is your original current and VC lags the current because the original waveform, sinusoidal waveform, starts from here. Okay, so that's why you are getting this phasor diagram. For your better understanding, I put this image here. Okay, now whatever theoretical part written here, it's up to you whether if you know the basic concept, no need to read. Okay, that's why I am spending so much time based to let you understand step by step. Okay, so whatever I told you, that is written here in theory. Now next, here the phasor diagram is also written like this. Okay, now look here, the phasor diagram of RLC series circuit where the VL value is greater than VC. Okay, so if your VL is greater than VC, so what will be your resultant y-axis value? This is your x-axis value. This is your plus y-axis. Okay, that is plus y-axis or imaginary, plus imaginary axis. This is your negative y-axis. So if VL is greater than VC in magnitude, okay, so what is your resultant value in y-axis? That will be VL minus VC. Yes. So now draw the resultant value. Okay. So this is your resultant voltage. That is nothing but your source voltage. Okay. And this is your current. So the circuit is basically lagging or leading with respect to I. Tell me, the circuit is of which type of, yes, with respect to I, correct. So you can say that with respect to I, the circuit is leading, okay? Or with respect to voltage, if this type of question is given, that with respect to voltage, what is the circuit's condition? Okay, then you will say that VS leads with respect to current by theta. Okay, and if it is said with respect to I, then what will you will say? That I lags with respect to
VS
by angle theta. Okay, so if nothing is said, remember, if nothing is said, then you have to say this one, last one, because you have to say, you have to write with respect to the reference value. Always remember, what is your reference? With respect to your reference, you have to explain everything. Okay, so this circuit is lagging circuit with respect to the reference. I can say that right? Because I is lagging in condition. Okay, so if I is lagging in condition, that means this circuit is inductive in nature, isn't it? Because what is the circuit diagram for inductor? The voltage is basically leading with respect to current, isn't it? तो यहां पे क्या हो रहा है, देखो वोल्टेज तो लीड कर रहा है विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू करंट. ओके, सो द सर्किट इज इंडक्टिव इन नेचर. कंसेप्ट क्लियर हुआ सबका?
यस सर.
यस सर.
ओके गुड. नाउ इफ आई एम सेइंग दैट VL इज लेस देन VC, then tell me what will be the nature of the circuit.
It is lagging, sir.
You are again answering the incomplete answer.
By angle theta something.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, so sir. Yes, sir.
You must tell that with respect to I, right? Because I is your reference. Always remember, I is your reference. So we will say that I leads the voltage by angle theta. Okay, so what will be the phasor diagram? Draw that in your copy. This is your I. Okay, see this type of question, you will forget if you don't practice, right? So one day by day you have to practice at least one numerical based on this, right? You have three observations on based on this one in that was experimented in your lab, right? So just practice. You have the data, so practice with those data. It will be very good. Okay, this is your VR, this is your
sir.
Net. Just a minute, let me complete this one. See, it is already 6:44. How will I allow it? I cannot allow him. Okay, I cannot allow him at this moment. I already told you that I will accept your entry up to the 15 minute of the commencement of the class. So try to make this discipline. You are going to be one engineer, so try to make some discipline, right? So I already gave you some relaxation time, 15 minutes, correct? I am not like others that wherever you want, whenever you want, I can allow you. I am not like that. Okay, so try to maintain some discipline. Clear? So see, you have your friends group, so based on this class, tell your friends that within 15 minutes, if they want, they can enter, and anytime they can exit. If they don't want to learn, they can leave the meeting anytime. Okay, I am here to teach you. I am here to make you understand. Okay. Okay, fine. Now continue. This is your negative y-axis, so this value is VC minus VL, correct? So this one will be your VS, and I will be in leading nature. So this circuit is your capacitive circuit. Okay, this is called, this circuit is capacitive in nature. Okay, now is the concept clear that you experimented in the lab? Now you can say easily that which one is capacitive, which one, what observation value gives you the inductive circuit. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So now you can see the this Z. Next one is the impedance of the circuit. So what is impedance of the circuit? You have the voltage triangle. Okay, I am just drawing the opposite one. Here, this voltage triangle is another one. I am drawing the another triangle. Okay, so here look, this circuit, this one. Okay, so I am drawing the two triangles, right? Try to understand, I am drawing the two triangles. Okay, so this value is your VR. This value is your VL minus VC. Okay, this value is your VS. So in place of VR, can I write I into R? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, now in place of VL minus VC, in place of VL minus VC, can I write I into XL minus I into XC? Can I write?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, in place of VS, I am writing I into Z. That is the impedance. I already told you what is impedance. Okay, in series, in a DC circuit, only resistance will oppose the current. Okay, but here, look, this Z is opposing the current because Z is called the impedance in case of AC circuit. Not only the resistor, that XL and XC also are the main culprits to oppose that current. Okay, they are helping that resistor. Resistor is already opposing, but XL and XC are saying, okay, I am there for you. I will again oppose the current. I will help you. Okay, so that's why this Z is much more than R. Okay, you can also explain this one, like, what is Z? Z is nothing but the Z square equals to R square plus XL minus XC square, isn't it? So you can say that Z square is greater than R square, correct? And Z is greater than R. You can say that very easily, correct? So you can say that impedance is much more than the resistor. Okay, now this is your total impedance, the magnitude of the impedance you are seeing, correct? Now from here you can get the value of theta. Okay, now if you take the cosine of this theta, that will give you the power factor, cos theta. Okay, that will give you the power factor. So what is the power factor value? The power factor value from this triangle, can I say VR by VS? Can I say this? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now from here, VR equals to IR and VS equals to I into Z. So can I say that this one equals to R by Z? Yes.
Yes,
so
yes,
you can calculate, if you can calculate the power factor of any kind of RLC series circuit by these two equations. Okay, now why this power factor is so important? Because of this power factor, you are paying your electricity bill. Okay, there is one reference power factor set by the electricity office. Okay, suppose the reference power factor is 0.86. I hope someone already calculated the power factor based on your lab experiment. Okay, and you are getting some power, you will get some power factor value. Okay, suppose this is your reference power factor set by your electricity department. Okay, but you are running more appliances. Okay, so whatever appliances you are using, all are maximum in inductive nature. Because just think, just imagine that, no, not imagine, just think that some oven, okay, some that electric oven you are using, okay, induction oven you are using. What is induction oven? Inside the induction oven, if you open that in the induction oven, then you will see inside there is one coil. Okay, so what is the meaning of coil? They are basically the combination of resistor and inductor. So all your appliances, maximum of your appliances are inductive in nature. Okay, so if your system is inductive in nature and capacitance value is very less, so your circuit will look like this, okay, for your home. And the cos theta will give you the this kind of value. Okay, and if you are using more devices, then this value, this power factor value may increase, may decrease. Okay, so based on that change, you have to pay the electricity bill. Okay, that is called the power factor tariff. Okay, because you have to pay, because if you ask your parents, then they are giving the electricity bill in quarterly basis. After 3 months, you are getting the electric bill, right? You don't know. After 3 months, you are getting the electricity bill. Yes?
Sir, I was waiting outside your message of 6 o'clock. So that's what I called him and said to join the class. So he's waiting outside.
Who?
Sir Sohail Khan.
So why he cannot join at that time?
Sir, his internet was off when that notice you have given. So that's what I called him and said to join the class because the class was started. So that's what he is trying to join. Please accept, sir.
But he is not here, I think. He is here. No, tell him to again join.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so if you ask your parents that then you will see that after 3 months you will get some electricity bill. Okay, and okay, tell them to join again because I just deny their admit. Okay, tell them, sir. To join again. Okay, so now I think this concept is clear to everyone that why this power factor is important. Okay, and what is power factor? Power factor is the angle between now why this power factor is important? The power factor is important because you have to pay based on this difference. Okay, now what is power factor? The power factor is the angle between the source voltage and the current flowing through the circuit. Okay, now next one is, you can see this one is the power factor value. Okay, Agneshwar Mukherjee and Sohail Khan,
yes, sir.
If you join like this, I will not allow you from the next class. Okay?
No, sir. I was actually not updated.
Sorry, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, fine. This is your last time. I am accepting your. Okay? So don't do like this. Try to maintain some discipline. Okay? I am giving you already 15 minutes for the commencement of the class. You can join till 15 minutes of the starting time of the class. After that, please don't. Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
So now this is your power factor calculation. Okay. Now this is the resonance part. Okay. What is the resonance? If you remember the first observation, what was there? The VS value was 118 volt, correct? You were getting VR value as almost 105 volt, as I remember. Yes or no? That was 105.
Yes, sir.
Exactly. And VL value and VC value are same. That is 100.
100.
Exactly. So if this type of condition you are getting, that means your setup is in resonance condition. Okay, now what is the meaning of resonance that you already learned in 11-12 physics? What is the meaning of resonance? Do you remember that? I hope you remember this example that some people were walking on one bridge, and if the frequency of the vibration of the bridge and the walking frequency of the people are same, then they will resonate in maximum frequency. That is called the resonance value, resonance frequency. I hope this example, you are familiar with this example. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is the meaning of resonance. That means here, if this kind of condition you are getting, then what is your net y-axis magnitude? That is zero, because VL minus VC is totally zero. Okay, so only VR is present in the system. Okay, so if VR is present in the system and current is flowing I, then what is the meaning? The whole circuit is resistive in nature. The whole circuit is resistive in nature. That is the concept of the resonance. Okay, and this amount of current is much higher than the normal current. Okay, if in normal case the current is flowing like 3 ampere or 4 ampere, then after resonance this current will increase up to the maximum value, 10 ampere or 12 ampere. Okay, you can see also from the observation. Okay, you can also see from the observation that the first observation's current value is much higher. Okay, because the whole circuit is resistive in nature and VL and VC values are same. Okay, so this condition, this particular condition is called the resonance condition. So if you are getting VL minus VC, so from here you can say that XL value must be equal to XC, isn't it? Because VL magnitude is I into XL and VC equals to I into XC. Okay, so this is called the resonance condition. Okay, now this is the series resonance circuit. You are observing here, this one is the series resonance circuit. Here R value is given, C value is given, and L value is given. Okay, so now we have to create the condition for this resonance. Okay, so if I want to create the condition, then I will write like this, because that is the only equation that is known to us. XL equals to XC, right? So what is XC? That is 1 by omega C. Okay, if you cannot understand one step, please repeat. please tell me that I need to repeat or I have not understand from this day. Okay, so this one is okay, I think. 1 by omega c equals to omega l, right? So from here, I am writing omega square equals to 1 by lc. Okay, so from here, I can say that omega equal to 1 by root lc. Okay, from here, what is the value of omega? Tell me.
Sir.
Yes.
2 pi f.
2 pi f. Yes. Who is speaking? The yes. Is there any problem?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, omega square is equal to 1 by lc. How, sir?
1 by root lc, because here omega square, omega is multiplied with this omega. So omega square equals to 1 by lc. So okay, I am doing the square root.
And yes, sir.
Okay, clear?
Okay, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, what is omega value? That is 2 pi f r, because this is the resonant condition I am speaking. So better to write here omega r. Okay, this value is omega r. This value is omega r, because this is one special condition. So don't confuse it with normal angular frequency. Okay, so this is your 2 pi fr equals to 1 by root lc. Okay, so from here, what is the value of resonant frequency? That is 1 by 2 pi root lc. So this is the special condition for resonance, that when your frequency is this value, then your circuit will be fully resistive and maximum amount of current will flow through the circuit, because whole circuit is resistive in nature. Only R is present in the circuit to oppose the current. The XL and XC will not help. Is this clear? The resonance concept is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now, next one is numerical. Okay, without solving this kind of numerical, just let's solve the numeric, the values you already have from the lab experiment. Okay, that will be much good. Okay, so I just stopped sharing the screen. Just a minute. Okay. Okay, one more thing. From next day onwards, when you give your attendance, only just write your roll number. No need to write your name. Okay, I have your name list and I already know your name with roll number. So only when you are giving your attendances, just write your roll number. That will be enough. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, let me open that window.
Sir, in resonance condition, if there is no need to conductor and capacitor and inductor, then can we just short circuit it?
No. You cannot short, because that is the, if there is no capacitor, there is no inductor, how will you say that it is in resonant condition? Yes, they must be present and their values are such that XL equals to XC, then you will say that, okay, this circuit is in resonant, this circuit is one resonant circuit. Okay, they must be present. Otherwise, you cannot say that this is resonant circuit. Is this clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. So, Okay, what was your source voltage that you have? That was Vs equals to 118, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we are discussing the resonant condition. Okay, since you already have those values. So Vr value is
105.54.
Exactly. The Vl and Vc 100. Values are 100 volt. Okay, and VRL value, you got what? VRL value?
150
volt. 151.8. 150 volt. Okay. So I am just redrawing the circuit. So if I did any mistake, then just knock me. Okay. This is your inductor. This is your capacitor. There is one small resistance because the circuit is impure. The inductor is impure. Okay. That is not the ideal case. Okay, so this is your C, okay, R comma L. Now, this is your voltage that you are giving here. Okay, so first, what we need to draw? The phasor diagram, correct? Because this is the case where VL equals to VC. So first, draw the phasor diagram. Now, here, current is this. Okay, what is the current value?
0.28
ampere. And this one is the maximum value you are getting with respect to the other values, right?
Yes, sir.
Because this one is resonant circuit. So with you will get the maximum value of the current in this resonant circuit. Okay, so this is your current because current is your reference value. Okay, next here, this voltage is your VR. Okay, so VR must be in phase. Okay, this value is I, this value is VR. Okay, now look, this condition. In this condition, this inductor is impure. Okay, that means one small resistor versus a small resistance is present in the circuit in this inductor. Okay, so if I draw like this, this is your resistor. Okay, a small resistance also present and one inductor. If I draw like this, this is only for your understanding purpose. Okay. This is only for your understanding purpose. This is your small r, this is L, and this is C. Now, okay, everyone give your attendance in the chat box. Okay. I have some of you already given. So if anyone left, give your attendance, okay, and continue this one. So here, look, what is your total resistance now? That is R plus R. So one small resistance VR is also present in the circuit. Yes, so that small resistance must be added with this VR. Okay, this is your small resistance VR. Okay. And what is your VL? This is your VL. Okay. Try to understand. This is your VL. Okay. So when you are connecting one voltmeter, okay, I am getting some noises. Please mute your microphone. When you put one voltmeter here, okay, one voltmeter value you are getting, this VLVC. So this value that you are getting is nothing but this voltage. Okay, this is your actual voltage you are getting. This is your actual voltage, that is VR comma L. Is now this clear? Okay.
Sir, repeat once.
Yes, sir, repeat again.
Okay. Now, try to understand. This inductor is impure. Right? So, if this inductor is impure, so we can draw like this one. Small resistor and inductor are in series. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, that's why voltage across this small resistor, VR, will be present here. So, I just draw here the small magnitude. Okay. And VL, the only inductor, the voltage across only the inductor, VL, must be in 90 degree in leading with respect to the reference value. Okay, so see this R and L, when you are taking the voltage across this R L, only the small r and L, V, R, L, then is your resultant value you are calculating. Now is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now is it okay to everyone? Clear, Goa? Okay. Now, this capacitor value, again, this capacitor value, okay, what is this capacitor value? That is also 100 volt. So I am drawing this one as the 100 volt. Okay, now this VRL value and VC value, VRL and VC. Okay, this is the capacitor value, right? So this is your actual phasor diagram. Now, how you are getting the power factor? Has anyone calculated the power factor for this resonant case? How much value you are getting? Do you remember?
0.95.
Exactly, 0.95. But in case of the pure resonant circuit, you will get the power factor as 1, because XL equals to XC, no Y axis value is there, right? So you will get the angle 0, isn't it? You must get the angle 0 for ideal case, but here you are not getting like this. You are getting some power factor value less than 1. Okay, do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that means the circuit is impure. That's why the circuit is resonant, but you are not getting the power factor 1. You are getting some value less. Okay, so now the values you are getting, this value you calculated. Okay, this value you calculated using the voltmeter. This value you calculated using the voltmeter. Okay, now our work is to calculate the power factor. How we will do that? Okay, let's draw it again. So I just explained you what values you calculated. Okay, now the final phasor diagram I am explaining. So if you understand this one, you can draw the phasor diagram of other two observations also. Okay, this one is your I. This is your VR. It will take again 10 minutes more. Okay, so try to be patient, because this one is very easy if you understand. Okay, so please pay attention here. Again, VR, V small r. Okay, if at any point you cannot understand, speak me. Okay, this value is VL. Okay, this value is VC. Okay, so if I want to draw the phase, the resultant value, then what we have to do? We have to add the real value, we have to add the imaginary value, and then we have to make the resultant, isn't it? That is the concept of the phasor, that is the concept of the vector, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So what are the real values here? This VR and this VR, isn't it? These are the real values. Okay, so I am putting this VR, I am shifting this VR here because we need to add this real values. Okay, this value is VR added. Okay, so what is the total value of this real in real axis? That is VR plus VR. Okay, clear? Next, VL and VC. Since this VL value, this VRL value that you already calculated is this one. This one is 100, the VRL value. Okay, so VL value must be some value less than 100, maybe 99, maybe 98. Okay, so ultimately, whatever value you are getting by doing your VL minus VC, they will be in minus y axis. Do you understand this one? Because using the voltmeter, try to understand, using the voltmeter, you calculated this value, VRL, isn't it? So VRL value is 100. So if VRL value is 100, what is the value of VL? That will be some value less, isn't it? So
yes, sir.
That may be 98 or 96 or 97, like that. So when you do this calculation, VL minus VC, that will be in minus y axis because VC is greater than VL, because VC value is 100. But VL value is 96. Okay, so all calculation will be in minus y axis. Okay, so I am just erasing this part. Okay, I am writing this above. This is your value of, this is your real axis value, that is VR plus V small r. Okay, and suppose this value you are getting as VL, or I can write VC minus VL because VC is greater. Okay, now calculate the resultant value. Okay, now calculate the resultant value. Okay, let me again erase this part. VR, this second bracket. Okay, this is your VR. Oh, this will be your smaller. This is your smaller. So what is your resultant value? This is your resultant value. So this value is your VS. Okay, so look here, a small angle you are getting, theta. Okay, now what was told you? To calculate the power factor, isn't it? The cos theta value you are getting is 0.95, correct? So now I am calculating the cos theta. So from the diagram, what is the value of cos theta you are getting with respect to VR and VS? What is the equation you are getting? Cos theta equals to, tell me.
VR plus small r by VS.
Exactly.
VR by VS.
Hmm. Correct. Divided by VS. Okay. Now, what is actually VR? That is I into R, correct? What is V small r? That is I into small r what is Vs? I into Z, isn't it? So R plus R divided by Z. Is this the equation written in the manual?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now it is proved with your theoretical concept. Okay, now tell me, if this small r, if this inductor is ideal, that means what? This small r equals to zero, only this small r will be equal to zero, then yes, it will be converted into R by Z. Now the ideal case and the practical case matches with each other. Okay, concept clear? But I hope now you can draw the phasor diagram very easily. Okay. Fine. So is there any problem in this calculation? Because I just had shown you with the practical values that you experimented in lab. Okay. Any confusion hai to batao? Because this is after this, I will not get any time to repeat this part. Okay. So is it clear now to everyone? ठीक से कर पाओगे ना तुम लोग? अब खुद से?
यस सर।